it's just that little piece of history that's making me think, yeah, this is my motivation, this is what I want to achieve.
A lot of people have written me off. It's all or nothing now. I've just got to give it my all.
This is my life. This is what I've been looking forward to for the last 4 years. It's the be all and end all.
For almost 4 years, the best amateur boxers in Britain have been working towards this summer's Olympic Games in Brazil. The Great Britain men's and women's squads spend Monday to Thursday every week living and training together at the English Institute of Sport in Sheffield. It's a grueling routine.
Oh, it kills me. I hate a Monday morning on that M1. Honestly.
Being a full-time athlete, training 3 times a day, being here Monday to Thursday and stuff, my body was just like, I thought, I can't do this, my body's going to break down. But like after a while, I just got used to it.
It's longer than a 9-till-5 job, really. It's like 7-till-7.
For Nicola Adams, Chantal Cameron and Savannah Marshall, the next 3 months will provide the only 2 opportunities they will get to qualify for Rio. It's a huge challenge, which comes with an enormous amount of pressure. They can afford to leave no stone unturned in their preparation.
So we get up and we do a check weigh at 7:15.
Sleep well, that's it.
No, not really.
From there, 7:30, we go to the track, we do a run.
We're all in the same boat, so it's nice to have someone to talk to. We think, oh, I'm dreading this run. And knowing that they're dreading it as well makes it seem a little bit better.
After that, we go back, we have breakfast, have a little rest, and then we go into strength and conditioning. And then we have the boxing session, where we do the sparring, the bags, the pads, and the skipping.
It's just routine, that's all it is. It's just the same thing, but it's the same with any job. All I know is a 9-to-5 ain't cutting it. Man, I work hard, you really think it's luck, innit? They say it's not what you know,
but who you know. Shut up, it's how hard you work and how good you flow. The 2012 Olympics brought an unprecedented level of success for GB boxing, with Nicola Adams one of 3 gold medalists. The girls know working to the blueprint set out by their coaches in Sheffield will give them the best chance of glory in Rio.
I think women's boxing is going from strength to strength, and you gauge that by the quality that's coming through.
They're as good as gold. They spar regularly together. Everybody's helping each other out. It is an individual sport when they get in there, but they realise that with the quality of sparring and quality of training they've got here, they make the most of it, so they'll be able to perform.
There you go.
Nikki's obviously the really experienced one. She's the, you know, European champ. She's the Olympic champ.
She's running very well. When Nicola Adams is running hard in the mornings, she performs better.
I think they just like to see me in pain and dying on the track, I think. I think it's more for their entertainment than anything else.
Lovely girl, Chantal. She's very quiet, but she's confident in her own ability.
The real positive with Chantal Cameron is her love of the sport. She absolutely loves it.
A fully fit Savannah Marshall, with her head right and confident, I think she's the best middleweight in the world.
I never, ever, ever thought that it'd become my job or anything like that. I think I've probably got the best job in the world, really.
She's got real quality. She's a former world champion. She's very young, she's very ambitious. She knows she's been injured and she knows now she's injury-free. So her confidence should be up, so she should really go for it. The women's game's moved on. There's at least 8 to 10 good quality females at every weight in the world now, so there's no easy medals anymore. The girls have got to get it dead right. They've got to listen to tactics. They've got to be driven, they've got to stay calm at the right times, and they've got to box their way through these qualifiers and hopefully onto a medal in Brazil. No easy task, but all 3 of them are capable of doing it.
The first chance to qualify for the Olympics would see the girls face the best in Europe, but only a place in their weight category final in Turkey would be good enough. At London 2012, Nicola Adams changed the face of sport forever as she became the first female Olympic boxing gold medalist. Now, success in the semi-final in Samsun would put her on the verge of creating history again, as she aims to become the first British female to retain an Olympic title.
Nicola Adams, the British representative, is onto the front foot. Her opponent, wearing red, Mariella Hansen, as they meet here for a place in the final, but more importantly, to secure their place at Rio 2016. An aggressive start from Adams. Beautiful left jab from Nicola Adams. She's boxed brilliantly so far. Really aggressive contest this one, both boxers going for their shots. Adams has found her range and is picking her punches wonderfully. The reigning Olympic champion will go through to Rio 2016.
I'm no longer on the road to Rio. I'm going to Rio, and it's an amazing feeling.
So success for Nicola. But the 33-year-old wasn't simply content to qualify, adding yet another gold medal to her impressive collection. For Savannah, the European qualifiers would prove to be a painful experience, as she suffered a shock defeat in her very first fight. Chantel's Rio hopes were also put on hold after she was beaten by eventual winner Yana Alexievna.
So I'm back for Thursday through to Monday morning.
Is it nice to come back?
Yeah, to see my friends and my family. So it's really nice. Obviously, I was in Turkey, then I had a week off. But I was like, training at home, but obviously it's different to Sheffield training. So then I come back to camp this week and my body's in bits. Monday, it's back to Sheffield again. So like Saturday and Sunday's like my best days where I just catch up with my family, catch up with my friends.
Were you always into combat sports then?
Mainly just kickboxing when I was really young. And so I started off in kickboxing and like there's the picture of me there when I was really young. I think that was like my first ever title belt. I was about 13 or something.
What did your mum and dad think to the fact that you liked? Did they encourage it?
To begin with, they thought I was just going through a phase. They thought, oh, she's not going to stick at this. And then, so my dad was like, he didn't like the fact of me fighting, but my mum's always been like the one who egged me on to get in the ring and stuff. Then my dad turned around to actually like seeing that I was good at it and seeing that I was dedicated. So then my dad became like one of my biggest fans. A little mutual there. These are world medals in kickboxing. I was world champion, British champion, Five Nations champion, and European champion. Guinness, come here. You're scared of the camera. Obviously, I was gutted because I didn't qualify in the Europeans. So I shut down from everybody for about 2 days. I didn't even contact my parents. And obviously, they was very sick about me, but I just wanted to deal with it my way. But straight away, I spoke to my coach at home. I spoke to my brother, like we had a massive phone conversation, and then I just started speaking to my friends like gradually, but it took me a while. I'm just looking as the world is like, hopefully it's my time, and obviously I'm going to graft that little bit extra, put that more work in, and just I'm hungry for it now, because like when I was out there and I didn't get the qualification, I was just like, I need to qualify. You actually realize how much it means to you, and like when I didn't get it, I was like, this means everything to me, like nothing seemed important anymore. And now I'm just like, this is all I want. Hello.
What's happening next?
Qualifier. Kazakhstan. My Thai boxing coach, she's somewhere around here. She's known me since I was like 16, so a little girl, and now she's watching me like, she's seen me progress into an athlete.
She was quiet, timid, 15-year-old, and I thought, okay, I'll see what we can do. And it was straight away, she just amazed me. When she started training with some of the guys, the bigger guys, even then her boxing was shining through, and some of the adult guys were like, whoa, who's this youngster beating us up?
My opinion wasn't really women and boxing. But Chantelle changed my opinion of her. She'd already been kickboxing, obviously, when she came to us, and she was looking to just improve her hands. But what I saw of her, and when I took her on the pads, I felt her energy, and yeah, she changed my opinion on women and boxing.
With one more chance to qualify for the Olympics, Chantelle would need to be at her best at the World Championships in Kazakhstan, where only a top four finish would secure a seat on the plane to Rio. It started brilliantly. A 46-second technical knockout in her first bout.
And we are underway, so stakes incredibly high. Chantelle Cameron's been working effectively behind the jab, the boxer in red. Now, a bit of a coming to... Oh, my goodness,
oh,
now
what's
that,
that
is harsh. There are two rings in operation here. Something was audible from the other ring. Putnam paused. Cameron well within her rights to take the free shot, and she's been issued a warning.
Chantelle Cameron did nothing wrong there.
Working away to the body is Chantelle Cameron. Putnam looking to tie her opponent up. Now hold on, we've got a warning for holding. We mentioned the fact that Putnam was going to have to watch how she conducts herself. So a warning has gone each way. So coming into the closing seconds of this fourth and final round. They prove to be the equal of one another. There's an eye-catching left hook from Putnam. Catching Cameron. Good right hand in response from Cameron, though. There's very little in this, but a successful two-shot salvo straight down the pipe from Putnam. In amongst all of the activity, and again, the action has stopped. And that is indeed the concluding bell for this contest. A hard-fought encounter in this, the second preliminary round. It's Mira Putnam. She is a split-decision victor over Great Britain's Chantelle Cameron.
I think Cameron is desperately unlucky in this contest. I really do.
A crushing defeat, which would end Chantelle's Olympic dream.
We're all very disappointed because, you know, Chantelle was one of the hardest working boxers on the squad. And, you know, it was a very nip and tuck affair. Unfortunately, she was on the wrong end of a close one. And, yeah, she's obviously very disappointed, as we all are.
Chantelle's a brilliant fighter in my mind. Chantelle's the best in the world. And I do hope she can come back from this.
She's a brilliant role model for female boxing because of the dedication and that fighting spirit that she has got. She's travelled around the world with this sport, she's fought the best and she's beaten the best. It doesn't matter what happens now. I'm proud of her anyway, what she's done already.
In the same weight category, Irish legend Katie Taylor had surprisingly failed to qualify in Turkey, but she sealed her place in Rio with a quarter-final win in Astana. The Olympic champion had to settle for bronze, though, after a semi-final defeat by eventual winner Estelle Maselli. In 2012, Savannah Marshall was the best middleweight in the world, but years of injuries, followed by the unlikely defeat at the European qualifier, have left her Rio hopes hanging in the balance.
When I was in school, I think I wanted to be a welder, I wanted to be a nurse, a teacher, everything you could think of apart from a boxer. I first started when I was 12 and it was just through friends basically. They were going to the boxing gym and I just went along. I was the only girl at the club for a good few years. It didn't bother me. I was comfortable, you know, training with all the boys. My mum and dad never said anything, my friends didn't say anything. It was all just accepted. I'm really lucky, really.
I love it, it's my gym. You know, some of the bags are battered and there's gloves with holes in, but it's my home. There's no other place where I'd rather train.
It took me 2 years to get my first bout. I just remember being really nervous. I would never ever tell anyone. I'd never even tell my mum or dad till about a couple of days before. And I'd be, oh, mum, I'm boxing in Birmingham in 2 days. I didn't want them going on about it, so I'd get more nervous.
Savannah Marshall takes the gold.
When I won the Worlds, that was when I actually thought, oh, I'm all right at this. I'm good.
The reigning World Championship gold medalist. It is Great Britain's Savannah Marshall.
I in the Olympics. I was ranked number one. I was the favourite to win gold, and it was all just too much for me. It really, really got to me. I just remember thinking what the occasion was. You know, everyone was talking about it. I think there was something like 20,000 people in the arena. I'd never ever boxed in front of that many people before. Everyone had it set in stone that I was going to win gold. I only needed to win one fight to win a bronze. And even winning a bronze, my life would have changed forever, and that's all I had to do. All I remember thinking is, I want to get home, I just want to go home. And when I was at home, I was kind of relieved that I'd left it all behind. It took me best part of 2 years to get over, I'd say. After the Olympics, I just wanted to get back in the ring and prove that, you know, I was good enough. So a lot of people have written me off since London because I haven't really been about. I've did two or three tournaments here and there, and then I'll go missing for 6 months due to injury. See people who have one operation and, you know, they go a bit AWOL. I had three, and I'm still here, and I'm still number one, and I'm still fighting to qualify. I'm fit and I'm strong, so I'm looking forward to it.
It's all or nothing now. We've got one more chance, so let's go out and do it.
With her final chance arriving at the World Championships in Kazakhstan, Savannah seemed to have found form and focus with two impressive early wins. Now she would face Li of China in the quarterfinals, where the prize was a place in Rio.
So into the opening round then, the Great Britain representative Savannah Marshall competing in her third bout of the tournament, having beaten the tournament number 5 seed in the second preliminary round. She had a bye in the first prelim round, and she's made a pretty bright start here, the boxer wearing blue, but so has Li as well. You'd expect nothing less when you're taking on the World Championship silver medalist and tournament number 3 seed. Marshall just getting to work behind a lovely left hand. The second of those jabs did get through after she fainted and half through the first one.
Working well behind the jab, Marshall. Started fairly well, and that wasn't a bad right hand either. But it's important, again, that when she lands those shots, if she does fall in, she's just got to switch the attack downstairs, and doesn't want to be holding on the inside or letting her opponents hold her. She just needs to just work when she's in the clinches.
Yeah, I think since Savannah's got the benefit of a slightly longer reach, she just needs to keep it long and keep out of distance, and as you say, keep popping them straight shots out.
In the third preliminary round, Li had a really comprehensive victory over Anna Laurel, the evergreen Swedish boxer who has made it through to the Olympic Games already. So both of them will be coming in full of confidence here. Plenty of thought. And again, we've got confusion. We've had that on a few occasions in this tournament. That's the sound from the other ring. Two rings in operation during the preliminary stages, both of them using a similar sounding bell. And you saw both boxers break off. That's the bell for this ring, concluding the end of the first round. That perhaps a fair reflection of the round of boxing we've just seen. Judges A and C favouring Marshall, Judge B favouring the work of Li. The instructions clear from Li Pullen, just ahead of the bell to start this second round. First round was split, Judge B favouring the work of Li. Judges A and C favouring the work of Marshall, and there's a cracking left hand, but the two boxers having moments of success during these exchanges, but perhaps the eye-catching shot during that cluster of punches from both boxers was the clean long left hook landed by Savannah Marshall.
I think Li Pullen wants Marshall to work more with the jab. He said don't lead off with the right hand, because she has got a great reverse 1-2 as Savannah Marshall, but if she misses the target with that right hand, then she tends to fall in a little bit. So he wants her to work better with the jab like it was there. That's a nice shot. Measure the distance, measure the gap with that punch, and then let the backhand go.
You use your jab as a rangefinder to make sure that you know the backhand's it. And then if you're leading off with the backhand, then you're not quite sure that it's going to hit the target or not. But if you're getting behind your jab, like Lee's saying, you'll know whether it's going to land or not.
Right hand to the body wasn't too far away from Marshall. Grappling at centre ring now. It's Marshall who is on the front foot and operating out of centre ring, runs into a 1-2 combination there.
That was good. And keeping your opponent on the outside, like I say, and you're literally showing the judges that you're in control in terms of the movement. You're keeping your opponent on the outside. You're dictating things.
Good right hand to the body from Lee.
Some lovely defensive work there for Marshall. She just blocked a lovely right hand from her opponent. He threw the shot and just kept that left hand nice and high and hit the gloves. Hope the judges have seen that. A good defensive work there from Marshall.
So the conclusion of the second round, another competitive round of boxing. Remember Lee, the tournament number 3 seed, now finds herself trailing for judges A and C by 2 points. It's tied up for Judge B, but Savannah Marshall in the ascendancy, having taken the second round for all 3 judges.
Tash, she's starting to work well, isn't she, behind that jab also, like we spoke about?
Yeah, she's just on occasion, she's just getting a little bit too close.
So into the second half of this 75-kilogram middleweight quarterfinal, Lee Pullen encouraging Savannah Marshall, telling her that she needs a big round. She's leading for judges A and C. It's all tied up for Judge B. There's a cracking right hand from Marshall, swiveling the head of Lee.
I think Lee Pullen wants Marshall just to work with the same urgency and intensity as she's been showing. Keep her on her toes. And I think she's responding well.
Lead right hook wasn't too far away from Lee. Saw her win Asian Games silver at the tournament in Incheon, South Korea back in 2014. And she losing to a boxer from North Korea. She demonstrated herself as a capable opponent during the course of that tournament, and here she is. Well, she's already qualified for the Olympic Games, but she wants some world championship hardware here to add to what she won 2 years ago in Jeju.
She's coming over the front foot just a little touch too much, Savannah, and she's fallen in and she's letting Lee get close, and it's crowding her away just a little bit. She needs just to lean back a little bit and give herself a bit more space. You can see her trying to get through with that uppercut.
Right hand wasn't too far away, but it's been a little bit untidy in this round. Corkscrew right attempted by Lee, but a good 1-2 combination from Marshall, and then back on the jab once again.
And that's when she's at her best, when she's got them long levers in someone else's face.
Yeah, straight punches and also working behind that jab. That's important, and that set up that 1-2 combination there, those two jabs beforehand. Straight shots, that's her strength, Savannah Marshall.
Right uppercut attempted by Lee. It's another competitive round of boxing. Lee pulling into the blue corner immediately. So Marshall in a really strong position now, leading on all 3 scorecards by 3 points for judges A and C, and by 1 point for Judge B. So plenty of encouragement from Lee Pullen, as there is for Lee as she rises from her corner, from her stall, to begin this fourth and final round.
That last round, I think it was a really close round, but I think they give Savannah the benefit of the doubt because she's trying to box and she's trying to keep it at long range, whereas Lee's happy to be close and happy to be hooking and wants to work on the inside.
And Lee Pullen just wants to now just to keep it going. He knows that she's so close to Rio. She just needs a good round. She's got to keep it going. She's boxing well. She's keeping it tight, working behind that straight left hand, straight right. She's boxing well, so she's got to keep it going here, Ronald. So close. Less than a minute and a half away from Olympic Games. That's what it's all about.
Most certainly is. Remember, Lee has already qualified. China, one of only 2 nations to have sent 3 boxers through in every weight class. for the women through to the Olympic Games. Morocco have done so as well. But Lee, well, she's come here after World Championship hardware to add to her burgeoning medal collection. But Savannah Marshall knows that it's Rio or bust, and that is why she is so keen to get her hand raised in this particular quarterfinal, because the final four in the middleweight tournament will go through to the Olympic Games this summer.
She's just trying to spoil Savannah a little bit here now, Lee. She's holding on, she's getting in close.
Marshall, though, working well with that jab and that 1-2. She knows she's got to keep working, on the inside, working well at range, but still carry on the attacks on the inside, and she's doing it. So I think she's outworking Lee in this round here, Marshall.
Both boxers will be feeling the pace, but it's an immense prize that awaits the victor, and that is why they're continuing to compete with everything they have. Right hand was blocked effectively by Marshall, and at the conclusion of that round, Savannah Marshall raises her arms immediately as she returns to her blue corner. Let's get the official announcement to see who is through to the final four, the medal stages. And in Savannah Marshall's case, Rio 2016.
You always get a bit nervous when the results take this long to come through. You can see the Savannah.
The winning points by unanimous decision in the blue corner, Savannah.
It's Marshall. Savannah Marshall, a unanimous points decision winner. She's got herself at least a world championship bronze, but the biggest prize of all is an appearance at a second successive Olympic Games.
I'm so happy, finally. I got beat in the first qualifier, and I've went and done it in this one. I'm so happy. I'm just all over at the moment. My emotions are all over. It hasn't set in.
Were you beginning to wonder after you went out in that first qualifier?
Yeah, I was thinking, oh, what is the point? What is the point? But now it's all paid off. This is the first time in a good year that I've been injury-free, and I've medalled at a major.
After 4 years of hard work, Savannah's success means that she will finally have the chance to avenge that London Olympic heartbreak. Before that, there's a World Championships semi-final to face.
So two rounds completed and there are two rounds to go. Savannah Marshall trailing by 2 points, 2018 across the board in favour of Nouchka Fontaine. Fontaine has been on the back foot in this manner, but then just planting her feet momentarily, holding her feet and shooting out what is invariably a 1-2 combination to pick off the advancing Marshall.
What she doesn't want to do is let this become psychological and get it beat down and be beaten. She wants to carry on like she's doing and just keep her hands up on the way out.
Fontaine's movement proving very effective on the back foot, taking the long route around the boxing ring. You know,
she's got it there. She needs to work.
So she needs to work. Yeah, you're right, Tash. On the inside, just a little bit more. You can see the odd feint as well as she's going forward. Sometimes Savannah walks. She plods forward, and she's a little bit predictable. So she needs probably the odd feint, just to show her opponent something different and not so predictable on that front foot as she's coming forward. And she's still taking the contest to Fontaine. She's just got to try and block a couple of shots going forward, hasn't she?
So into the second half of this round.
One-two
was parried effectively by the gloves and forearms of Marshall. And she comes forward once more and lands with a big right cross. But look at the good footwork from Fontaine as she pirouettes her way back to the middle and the space of the boxing ring. So a little bit of clinching. Perhaps for the first time in the contest now. It's been forwarded quite a clip for two big middleweight boxers. Fontaine trying a shot underneath. Savannah Marshall remaining on the front foot and poking out that left jab.
She just can't get the range of a backhand at the minute. A backhand keeps on missing. It's missing with the jab and missing with the backhand.
that was a good round, okay? Let me let you know. That's exactly what I want to have. I need you to be busy. I need you to defend what comes back at you. Drag it in there. Slowly.
Lee Pullen in the corner there. He's fairly happy with that last round. So it'll be interesting to see how the judges see it. But going forward, that's a nice shot there from Marshall. She's still got to block the odd shot that's coming back from her. And she's probably, what Tasha said earlier, she's probably got to improve her accuracy a little bit better. The quality just isn't quite there from Savannah. Let's have a look at these scores now, because Lee Pullen was quite pleased with her in that round.
Well, she's got a share for Judge B, so she is trailing by 1 point for that observer, but by 3 points for Judges A and C. As we go into the fourth and final round, the boxer wearing blue, the tournament number two seed and number two ranked boxer in the world, Nouchka Fontaine, is in a commanding position. She leads by 3 points, 30-27 for Judges A and C. Savannah Marshall has been committed. She's been on the front foot, taking it to her opponent, but she has been picked off as she's advancing. And the greater success has been coming from the flashing blue fists of Nouchka Fontaine. Marshall has had success of her own, though. Fontaine will know that she's been in a contest. But can Marshall do something dramatic to overturn the deficit that she's facing in this fourth and final round as she attempts to get to her second World Championship final?
I think she's been a touch unlucky with the scoring, actually, to be quite honest, because some of these rounds, I think, have been quite close. But we certainly haven't rewarded Savannah for that front foot pressure. Obviously, she's getting caught occasionally coming in. But I have seen a lot of judges that prefer that front foot boxing that would award her for that, but not tonight.
30 to go, Lee Pullen giving the instructions from that red corner. Both of these boxers booked their place for Rio here after being eliminated at the preliminary rounds of the AIBA European qualification event. So they faced a fair amount of pressure to make it through to this stage. They have duly done so. Savannah Marshall will contest her second consecutive Olympic Games. Nouchka Fontaine will be there for the first time. And it looks as though she's going to improve on the bronze medal that she picked up in Jeju 2 years ago. As Marshall lands a good right hand there, the boxers exchange jabs. The assurance that she built up for judges A and C over three completed rounds made this fourth and final round a very difficult task indeed. Sixth time that these two boxers have shared a boxing ring. One suspects that the margin of advantage is going to continue to be tilted in Fontaine's favour. So Nouchka Fontaine makes it through to her first World Championship final. Savannah Marshall comes away with a World Championship bronze to add to the one that she won 4 years ago.
It's really frustrating, but she's a world-class fighter and I'm just happy I'm losing to the best and not some Joe Bloggs. I have qualified, so I've got 8 weeks, so I'll get her in the Olympics.
So what's this week done for your confidence, your self-esteem, your self-belief?
This time last week, I was thinking, God, what am I going to do if I don't qualify? I might have to get a new job. But now I don't, so...
American Clarissa Shields would eventually take the middleweight world title. Since winning gold in London, Nicola Adams' life has changed dramatically.
Nicola Adams has just made history by brilliantly boxing her way to the first ever Women's Olympic boxing title.
Oh, that was an amazing year. I just remember the build-up and all the people and just how excited everybody was about the Olympics and how excited I was to be a part of it. I just remember thinking, like, wow, this is a dream come true. The knockdown surprised me the most, I think. I was like, wow, I was in shock myself. I hear the crowd roar, I'm like, yeah! And then go back to the car, I'm like, okay, she's getting up. I need to focus.
Didn't she box brilliantly from opening bell to last?
I was like, I've done it. I'm Olympic champion, I've won. It was the most amazing feeling of my life. I really, really miss my dogs when I'm away. My mum always sends me videos.
You've got another dog, right?
Yeah, Dexter. He's a Doberman.
He's not here at the minute.
No, he's pretty safe. So this is my medal from the European Championships. And it was the qualifiers for the Rio Olympics. So I'm really, really happy about this one. This one's the key to me going to Rio. So, but it doesn't all end there for me. I want to go to the World Championships in a couple of weeks and hopefully win a gold medal there as well. I've got a lot of hard training to do. We've got a multi-nation camp next week. But for today, it's just my rest day today, so I'll be chilling out on the settee with the dog and watching some Game of Thrones. Going into this qualifiers, I felt like an all more rounded athlete. I know what it's like, I know what the pressure's like, and I know exactly how I'm going to feel getting into the ring and getting ready to fight for my place for Rio.
Does that put more pressure on you?
No, I actually thrive under pressure. I actually like having the pressure there. It makes me perform better than I would normally. Normally I'm just like, yeah, okay, you know, I'm gonna go out and win this, but it's like, no, I really have to win this. There's so much more on the line for me, and that's what makes me perform that little bit, give that little bit extra, I think. The same thing at the Worlds, I really, really want this gold medal. I've never had one at the World Championships. I've got the Europeans, I've got the Olympics, I've got the Commonwealths. This is the only one that I'm missing. I always wanted to do the second Olympics, and I wanted to do the Commonwealth Games as well. It was the first time that we'd ever had women boxing in the Commonwealth Games, so I wanted that little bit of history, and then on to Rio. I don't think we ever had a double Olympic champion in boxing before, male or female, so I wanted that little bit of extra history as well. Calm down, he's only moved. What's up with you? He's started up again.
With Olympic qualification already secured, Nicola's sole focus for the World Championships would be claiming the last remaining title to evade her. After battling through a tricky quarterfinal, Nicola finds herself one step away from the gold medal bout.
So we're into the second round of this 51-kilogram flyweight semi-final. The boxer wearing red out of the southpaw stance has come out very quickly indeed, and that is Zhaina Shekabekova. She's conceded the opening round for all three of the scoring judges who are using the 10-point must system. Remember, she's the tournament number 8 seed, ranked 10th in the world. It's the second encounter between these two boxers. When they met a couple of years ago at the Felix Stamm Memorial Tournament, it was Nicola Adams who came out on top. How significant will that result be? Shekabekova, 26 years of age, part of a full-strength Kazakhstan boxing team. Lovely left hand from Adams, continuing to disrupt the attempted forward movement of Shekabekova.
That's a little nice jab as well. This contest now is suiting Nicola, because she's starting to wait and she's bringing her opponent onto shot, so she's getting the timing right. It's important that she triggers the opponent off. And very often, a southpaw coming forward can be easier to hit with that right hand because they close the gap down themselves, and it looks like Shekabekova, Tash, her feet are quite slow, aren't they? And that's suiting Nicola. She can get the shots off.
Yeah, we've got to remember Nikki's she's a seasoned professional in the amateur sense.
Yeah.
She's fought many southpaws along some of the best in Sofia Rochageva, so she knows how to handle herself at a southpaw, and she's working on experience. Plus, she can switch herself like she just has there.
I think that the pace is suiting Ronald at this stage. Nicola Adams, she's just waiting on the outside look, and Shekabekova, her feet are far too slow, so that's just allowing Adams just to use that jab, straight right hand. I think she's doing well up to this stage, Nicola.
Just a reminder that here in the Olympic weight classes, 51 kilograms, of course, is one of the weights that will be contested in Rio, as it was in London. But making it through to the bronze medal bout, the final four stage, that has ensured the passage of all of these semi-finalists through to Rio 2016. So that's that part of the job done. Now they are boxing for the best possible World Championship medal. Let's listen in to Dave Alloway.
We've still got their jab going. It's too long in between the jabs, all right?
Yeah.
Don't step in.
Dave Alloway's there saying don't step in with it. So he wants to bring the opponent onto that shot. If she steps in with it and falls short, then Shekabekova will actually come back with her own counters.
It's So Nicola Adams has taken both of the opening rounds.
Seconds out.
For all three of the observing judges, she's in a strong position going into the second half of the contest. So two rounds completed, two rounds to go, and Nicola Adams of Great Britain, a three-time World Championship silver medalist, looking to book her place in another World Championship final, where she hopes to contest for World Championship gold, just stepping through with that right hand, ending up in a southpaw stance momentarily, but she's looking comfortable up there, but she did take a swift left hand from Shekhabekova. She's two rounds down, she's getting desperate perhaps, and so one can expect or anticipate an increase in tempo and work rate from the boxer wearing red.
Nikki's got deceivingly long arms, and she just needs to keep popping her jab out like she was in the first two rounds and using her reach to keep her at the end of it. Like Dave was saying before, she doesn't need to step in and get involved. She can just box off her jab and stay in control. She gets caught with silly shots here.
Another big left hand from Shekhabekova.
Natasha, obviously you've been in the same team as her. She is a toughie though, isn't she, Nicola? She will stand and train. She don't mind taking the shot. She's got great skills, but she's tough as well, isn't she?
Oh yeah. If you want to beat her, you can't beat her at a boxing match. And if you want to stand there and trade with her, she'll stand there and trade with you.
Jaina Shekhabekova, as well as those lofty world rankings, high seedings in this tournament. 2010 Asian champion, coming away with a gold medal at 54 kilograms. She was the 2014 Asian Games silver medalist here at flyweight. I was over at that tournament in Incheon, and she acquitted herself very well indeed. Second appearance at the World Championships here, as Adams continuing to work really effectively behind that long left hand. And when she utilizes that shot, well, really, Shekhabekova becomes a peripheral figure in the contest.
See, that was great movement there from Nicola, in and out with the feet and scoring well with the jab. Good boxing skills, showing good variation with that footwork in and out.
So Shekhabekova had her moments during the course of that third round. She had a couple of periods of success with eye-catching left hands. Just listening to what Dave Alloway has to say.
All right, you have to keep your shape. You have to keep your shape, all right? You can't just jump in, all right? It's basic stuff for 2 minutes now. Sharp. Everything's got to be sharp.
Good work from Nicola Adams in this round. I thought her feet were very good. She was in and out. And I think what Dave Alloway's talking about there, he just wants to cut out any mistakes. He knows that she's home and dry. She's only 2 minutes away. She's just got to keep her boxing going.
And there it is. Third round completed. All three of them scored the same way for all three of the scoring judges. Into the fourth and final round then, and Jaina Shekhabekova, the tournament number 8 seed, has come out very quickly indeed, because she is trailing, having conceded all three of the completed rounds to Nicola Adams, the tournament number 5 seed. She's currently ranked 6th in the world, Nicola Adams, but she comes in as the reigning Olympic champion, the reigning European Games champion, the reigning Commonwealth champion, all multi-sports events where Nicola Adams has embraced the stage of a multi-sport competition. She would dearly love to secure her first World Championship gold medal here. She's got one foot in the final already, and as Dave Alloway was pointing out, in calm, measured fashion in the corner, she scored with a beautiful Czech right hand before pivoting away and turning the tables on Shekhabekova. All she has to do is produce 2 minutes of mistake-free boxing, and she will be through to another World Championship final.
Shekhabekova doesn't want to come in wild, because that'll shoot Nikki down to the ground and she'll just pop it off and hit her with singles and doubles. Nikki's far too experienced for someone to just walk straight as she's doing, and she'll just pick it off and move and go again.
And not too long ago, Kazakhstan, Ronald, were actually over here sparring with us, and I remember this girl coming over, she sparred Nicola in the sessions. So I think psychologically going into this contest, Nicola looked very confident early on, and because she's obviously got a victory over her as well, but because of those recent spars, Nicola had her number in the sparring up at Sheffield at GB. And you've got to say it's good work by Rob McCracken again for inviting someone like Kazakhstan over, and we've got the better of this girl here in this contest with Nicola.
After the afternoon session here at the Baris Arena, Kazakhstan had qualified 3 out of 3 for the gold medal bouts, but one suspects they're about to suffer their first loss at the semi-final stage here of the 4 boxers that they've had contesting the these bronze medal bouts, because Nicola Adams hasn't put a foot wrong over the course of this 4 2-minute round bout. In her second contest against Zhaina Shekhobekova, Nicola Adams looks to have earned a repeat victory. Let's get the official announcement. Nicola Adams, the tournament number 5 seed, is through to her fourth World Championship gold medal bout. Her pursuit of her first World Championship title remains alive.
I knew I was going to be up against it, home nation fighter, and I had to just give it everything I had. I took care of it, you know, it's just business in there. That's my office. I've come to get that gold medal. Hopefully I can get it tomorrow. This one means everything to me. If I can get this one and complete the set, I don't even think happy expresses how happy I'll be.
It's finals day in Astana. All eyes on Nicola. Time to shine for Britain's golden girl.
So the opening bell sounds in this World Championship gold medal bout in the 51-kilogram flyweight division. Representing Great Britain wearing red is Nicola Adams, the reigning Olympic champion, the reigning Commonwealth Games champion, the reigning European Games champion, looking for her first World Championship gold medal, having come away with 3 silver medals in the past. And her opponent competing in her 4th World Championships here, this her best ever result, surpassing the quarterfinals that she made back in 2010, and that is Pyamwillai Laupiam of Thailand.
It's important that she establishes that jab. We've said it many times about Nicola. Once she gets into a rhythm behind that shot, then she sets up that backhand. But earlier on, she just led with her right hand and just fell short and got caught with the long left hook from her opponent. So it's time to get behind that jab, establish a lead, and then everything will come from behind that punch, Tash.
Yeah, she wants to get the first round out of the way, get it under her belt, and then move into the second round. But it's quite tight at the minute. They're both throwing shots, blocking. Both guards are good at the minute.
5th bout of the tournament for both of these boxers. And Nicola Adams has faced a whole variety of styles and athletes of differing stature as well. Her quarterfinal win was incredibly close fought over Lin Yuting, the talented 20-year-old from Chinese Taipei. She was considerably taller than Nicola Adams. And the youngster acquitted herself very well indeed, but Adams found a way to solve the puzzle, but it was an incredibly close contest. More comfortable victory yesterday over the tournament number 8 seed, Zhaina Shekhobekova of Kazakhstan. Both boxers looking to establish their rhythm and range during this opening round. And as you'd expect, perhaps, it's a cagey start to this bout for World Championship gold in the flyweight division. Let's see if we can listen in to Dave Alloway.
Breathe. Good. Oh, right, OK. So what we need to be doing is going twice a bit.
Yeah.
So defensively, when you're moving away, which is good, you're not getting it.
Yeah.
Which is good, all right? But we need sharper counters when she actually does come to you, OK? Mm-hmm. But we need that pressure on the front foot and push it from side to side.
Good advice there from Dave Alloway. He's quite pleased with what she's doing. She's working behind her jab. He's talking about the good foot adjustments. But Tash, she's got good movement, hasn't she? With the feet, she can move in and out, and she's very skillful doing that.
Yeah, her movement's one of her strongest assets. You can see from the score, 2 judges have given it to Nicky.
So into the second round then. And the scorecard, perhaps a fair reflection of what was a very cagey, cautious opening round. Nicola Adams starting this second round on the front foot and trying to establish that left jab. But judges A and B scoring the opening round for Nicola Adams. That's a good 1-2 combination. But back comes Laupiam with a right hand of her own.
It's a good start from Nicky Adams in this round. Look, she's on that front foot now. That's, for me, is her strength, like Tashi said, is her movement. But she moves in with the jab, and then she adjusts her feet, so she comes back on the outside, you see. So she's always thinking about safety. See how she adjusted then, just to avoid the counters? She's clever. That's her strength, in and out movement.
When Laupiam moves away, she moves away with her hands quite low. So if I was Nicky, I'd go and go again.
So she's come just, I think what Dave was trying to say was just come a little bit out of range so that she can't get you, but then go back in.
Go back at her, yeah.
Lots of fainting. And the referee reminding the two boxers to engage, but they're thinking and trying to fashion openings. Oh, that's a cracking right hand straight down the pipe from Adams, driving Laupian backwards. She gets herself beyond punching range just to get herself reorganized after shipping that big right hand. Good left hand to the body from Adams, who's really beginning to establish and demonstrate her variety now. Spearing left hand once again, and this is a good portion of this second round for Nicola Adams.
I think Laupiami is struggling a little bit with the movement of Adams. She's working really well, and that straight right hand, Tash, that 1-2, that's a strong point for her, isn't it?
It is, and like I said, you're seeing it again there. She's just leaving her lead hand out, trying to keep Nikki at the end of her jab, trying to get some distance to reset herself. If Nikki can go and go again, she'll catch it every time.
She's experienced some uncomfortable moments during the course of this second round, Laupiami. The 10-second clap has sounded. There's another right hand once again, and that has been a particularly profitable punch for Nicola Adams during the course of that second round. The first round, remember, judges A and B scoring for Adams, judge C scoring for Laupiami. But it seemed to be a far more dominant round for the reigning Olympic champion in that second stanza.
I thought this was a really dominant round for Adams. She worked very well indeed. She stepped on it. Some good 1-2s, some good straight lefts. Look at this for a 1-2. That's a super combination there from both the left and right.
Well,
that's a bit surprising because I thought that Nikki won that quite comfortably.
So the scorecards in the second, identical to the scorecards in the first, which is a bit of a surprise. So into the second half of this 51 kilogram flyweight gold medal bout here at the Baris Arena in Astana. Good right hand over the top from Laupiam. Nicola Adams enjoyed what appeared to be, from our commentary position, a pretty dominant round. That right hand that she just threw there was a particularly effective shot. Caught Laupiam with it repeatedly, and again the spearing left hand in evidence from Nicola Adams, but judges A and B favoured the work of Adams in both rounds 1 and 2. Judge C has favoured the boxing produced by Laupiam in both of the opening two rounds.
It's important that she just gets probably a little bit closer. She doesn't want to be jumping in too much and starting the attack from too far away. So she's got to move in with that front foot, lead hand, measure the distance with the jab and then bring the right hand through. But it's important that she doesn't do that from too far away, because on the odd occasion she may fall short.
Great Britain sent 5 boxers to this World Championships. Nicola Adams had already qualified by winning the gold medal at the European qualification event in Samsun earlier this year. Good left-right-left combination from Laupiam, perhaps best combination of the fight for her. So Nicola Adams, being the competitor that she is and the experienced boxer, will know that she will have to do something equally eye-catching to resonate in the minds of the judges. Laupiam now stamping that front foot and fainting, trying to fashion an opening for herself.
We've talked before about when it's close, about them one or two things that are eye-catching to the judges that this sway it, and that could have been one of them things. So Nikki needs to do something in these last couple of seconds like that.
Right-hand lead wasn't too far away from Adam. The 10-second clapper has sounded, closing seconds of this second round. A little bit of confusion between the boxers and the referee there. But another competitive round of boxing in that third round.
That's it, plenty of time, loads of time. Yeah, nice, good. That's it. All right, so you've got 2 more minutes. We don't leave anything in the tank, all right? But we be nice and sharp. Get your front foot there where it needs to be.
Oh, just saying there to get that front foot. I think he's seen it as well, as you've got to get a little bit closer. I think this was a closer round. I think Laupiam had some success in this round. Whether she did enough to win it, I'm not too sure. She probably did on the one judge, because the one judge seems to be favouring her. Yeah, again, see. So Judge C is favouring everything that the Thai boxer is doing. She likes her style.
A Well, we move into the fourth and final round, and Great Britain's Nicola Adams, in search of her first World Championship gold medal, is leading this contest for judges A and B by 3 points. Judges A and B have given Adams every round, but she eats a big right hand there from Lau Piam. Judge C has favoured the work of the boxer in blue in the three completed rounds so far. So very much a question, or at least we deduce from those scorecards, that Judge C prefers the style and the work of Lau Piam, judges A and B preferring the boxing of Adams. So potentially now less than a minute and a half between Nicola Adams and her first World Championship gold.
Well, Lau Piam is sitting back and she's waiting for Adams to come in to try and land that right hand. So Nicky's got to double up that jab. There you go. That's what she's got to do. Double up the jab, then throw the right hand. Maybe double the attack up and keep the attack going. A single attack, she might get caught with the right hand here and there.
Nicky needs to keep that lead hand just up a little bit. She keeps on getting caught over the top when she's bringing the jab back slow or bringing it down low.
Again, both boxers really thinking about their attacks, trying to trigger something off which they can counter. Inside the final 30 seconds, though. And remember, good lead right hand one from Adams once again. Lau Piam tried the same shot, but it was a little bit long. So in the closing stages now, Nicola Adams has one hand on the gold medal, given the status of this contest coming into the fourth and final round. And the feinting and the studying continues. Good left jab from Lau Piam. The 10-second clapper has sounded. Adams onto the front foot once more. Good exchange of shots between the boxers. And as the closing bell sounds, Lau Piam raises her arms immediately, but I suspect that's in more hope rather than expectation, because Nicola Adams was leading this contest by 3 points for judges A and B coming into the fourth and final round. Let's get the official announcement, which we think will see Nicola Adams crowned as a world champion in the flyweight division. And she's done it! Nicola Adams jumping for joy in the ring here at the Barris Arena. She completes her gold medal collection from major tournaments by claiming her first World Championship gold. She has done so by split decision after another brilliant boxing display over Thailand's Piam Wilai Lau Piam. She comes away with World Championship silver, but Nicola Adams absolutely ecstatic. The reigning Olympic champion, the reigning European Games champion, the reigning Commonwealth champion, at last can call herself a world champion.
I can't believe it. I've finally done it. After 3 silver medals in the World Championships, I finally got that gold. And what better year to do it? The year of the Games. So I've cemented my place in history as well. Quite a touch and go fight. She's a really good opponent. She deserved to be in the finals. But I just gave a little bit more. I just wanted it that much more, I think, in the end. 2 out of 3 down. I just need that last one now. The champ is here.
Drive, determination, dedication, a relentless will to win, and a commitment to do whatever it takes to make that happen. These are the things that mark out champions, history makers, coming back from the depths of injury and despair to take on the world again. Inspirational. Putting it all on the line, even though the price of failure will be devastating. For Nicola and Savannah, their journeys will take them to Rio de Janeiro this summer, where the greatest prize in sport awaits.